Officials with the Office of the Medical Investigator say they have received all of the body parts from Kansas City in the BioCare case, but they're not getting as many positive IDs as they had hoped for. Action 7 News reporter Brian Martin joins us live with that story. Brian.
Yeah, hey, Royal, I'm here in front of the old BioCare offices here in the Northeast Heights. You can still see the red tags up on the building. Now, I spoke with the Office of the Medical Investigator today. They tell me they still have a lot of work to do.
Officials with the Office of the Medical Investigator say they may have to turn to a different kind of DNA testing to confirm identities on some of the bodies removed from BioCare. It's been a long and painstaking search for IDs since crews in hazmat suits left the BioCare offices back in April.
The name of the building is BioCare, but right now it's a biohazard.
The owner of the company is charged with fraud for shipping body parts to an incinerator in Kansas City. Since then, the body parts have been shipped back here to Albuquerque. Officials with OMI say they've done everything they can do, logging, photographs, everything except sending off DNA samples to the labs, which could happen in a few days. OMI's worked very closely with the crime lab, trying to match up names with the bodies, but there's only so much the crime lab can do. And that's why the lab may have to look for outside help to identify the remaining body parts.
And that is not a very easy process. They tell me it could take several more weeks before they are able to positively identify, if they are at all, those bodies. Reporting live, Brian Martin, KOAT Action 7 News.
And the owner of BioCare, Paul Montano, was arrested and charged with fraud. He posted his $10,000 bond.